Hi everyone, and welcome to the next lesson in this series on Django Fundamentals, where we will be taking a closer look at how to render data into a template. Okay, so let's get straight to it. All right, so we're going to start off very simple. So let's go to our views first. So under our app, so in this case it's to do, we want to go to views.py. Okay, and we're going to be working with the homepage for now. So we can also bring up the index.html template here, so the template page here for our homepage. And what we're going to do is we want to create a dictionary. Okay, so to create a dictionary, of course, it will be with curly braces. Okay, so let's keep this very straightforward. So what we can do is we can assign a context dictionary here. So we can simply just say context equals and our dictionary here. And I want to place in here our key and our value. So a key and a value. So to do that, we can just say first name will be our key. And our value, I want to say John Smith. Okay, so we can call this creating a context dictionary. Okay, so what we could simply do is just place the dictionary here. Okay, we can do that actually to try it first. We can paste it here and take this away. So this is one way we can do it. We can pass in our dictionary just like that with our key and our value. Okay, so I just want to take this away so it looks a bit better. Okay, and then we would render our key per se in index.html. So we can go here and we could just say what is our key? So we must render by the key. The key is first name. So we must make sure when we render data into a template that we use double curly braces. Okay, so when we go to our homepage and refresh, we'll see there John Smith. So this is basically how we would render data into a template. Okay, and when we're working with more dynamic data later on in the series, this is how we would do it. Pretty much. Okay, but this is a simple way of doing it. We can change this up. So instead of passing this dictionary here, it'll look a bit ugly. We can create a context dictionary, which I meant earlier, where you just say context. So you can give this, you can call it context, that's a good name. And you can simply take this out. Okay, and we can actually just go back to how it was here. And what we would basically be saying would add a third parameter here. And of course, you would say context equals context. Okay, so this would be referring here. So if we were to check, that's fine. And we were to refresh, it would be the same thing. So I just changed value here. Let's go back. And there we go. Perfect. So this is the basic way of rendering data into a template. So what you would do is the best way is to create a context dictionary here. Reference it. And then in your HTML template, you would reference your key of your dictionary per se. And then you would ensure that you place two double curly braces around here. Just to reference the value here of John Smith. Okay, so that is the first part. Okay, let's look at the second part. Okay, so let's change this up a bit. So what we're going to be doing is we're going to be making use of tags for the first time here. So we want to include sort of like Python-like logic in our code now. So basically, let's make this a bit more understandable. I want to just create a variable here. So I'm just going to say name equals John Smith. And I'm going to pass the variable as the value. Okay. And I'm going to put name here. And I'm going to switch this actually so you can see the difference, Luke Warren. Okay, so let's go and refresh. And there we go. So you could see here we're passing in our variable name as the value. Now let's say we want to do perform a few if statements on this. Okay, so we would then effectively create a tag. Okay, so let me show you what I mean. So let's take this away, and we would be creating a tag. And to create a tag in Django, we would use our curly brace and put a percentage sign, percentage sign. You may have already seen this earlier in base, in for example, here. Here we're using tags as well. So a tag is with these two percentage symbols and curly braces at the sides. So of course Django has built-in tags that it uses, but we can also create sort of our own logic based on these tags. So what we'll be doing is something very simple. We're going to, of course, reference our key in our dictionary, and we can simply say something like if first name, okay, which we pass through here in these tags, is equals to, I'm going to say, what's his name? Luke Warren. So let's see, Luke Warren. Okay, and then what we can do is we can write some code if that is correct, and it's going to say welcome Luke Warren. Okay, there we go. All right, if that fails and it's not the case, we would then have else. And then we would have some code just saying wrong person. Okay, very simple here. And then at the end, we would just have an end if, because we need to close off, we have to close off our if statement here. So we can just, yeah, we can keep it like that. That's perfectly fine. So let's test this out. So we have our key and it's checking if the name is Luke Warren, so the value. So it's checking this value here, which we've set to Luke Warren. And if that works, it's going to say welcome Luke Warren. Else, it's going to say wrong person. And here we just simply end our if statement here. So if we refresh, it's going to say welcome Luke Warren. Okay, now let's change our value here. And I'm going to say back, I'm going to put it back to John Smith. So in this case, it's the value is no longer Luke Warren. It is now John Smith. So it's going to run the else statement here. So when we refresh, it's going to say wrong person. Okay. So that's basically how we can use tags here to help us write our own sort of Python styled logic. Okay. All right. So there is one more thing that I'm going to show you, and that will be the way that we will render data from now on, especially when we're rendering dynamic data. Okay. Right. Okay. So let's make this a little bit more advanced. Okay. So I'm just going to remove all of this. Okay. Let's refresh. See, it's gone. Yeah, it's clear. Okay. That's good. Let's go to our views. And I am just going to take everything out for now. Take all this out. And make sure it's clean. Yeah, it's clean. Okay. So what we're going to do now is we're going to go full on now. So what we're going to do is create a list. Okay. And then what we're going to do after that is we are going to have dictionaries in our list. Okay. So what we want to do is we want to loop through all of our data. Okay. So this is very effective, especially if you've seen probably on any social networking site where you see the profiles of lots of people. For example, when you're searching, it loops out all the relevant search results. So we're going to do something similar. We're going to loop through all of our data. Okay, so let's start off. So I'm going to create a list. So in this case, I'm going to call it client list. Okay, and of course, I need to use the square brackets here. And I'm going to create my dictionary. So I'm going to create two dictionaries. So I'm just going to leave these open for now. Okay, perfect. And I'm going to pass in some keys and values. So I'm just going to say each one will have an ID. So we can see these as sort of like attributes per se. So I'm going to have a few things here. So I'm going to add name. So I'm going to say John Smith. Okay, so remember to add your commas as well. And I'm going to add profession as well. And I'm going to say web developer. Okay, good. And I'm just going to copy the same here and just modify it just a little bit. Okay, so I'll of course change the ID to 2. And I'll put it like the previous example, Luke Warren, like that. Change the profession and I'm going to say accountant. Okay, so there we go. So we have our list, which we are calling client list, and we have two dictionaries And we can see, of course, our attributes as follow, and we have our values assigned to that. Okay, so what we want to do is, in order to actually loop through this data and make it usable, we need to go ahead and create a context dictionary. So remember, context equals, and we're going to pass in our key and our value. Okay, so the key we can simply call client. And our value is going to come from our list here. So this would be client list. That would be where our value. So you can treat these dictionaries here as like an individual sort of object. Okay, that's the way that you can treat this here. And we can simply do the same we did before. We can say context equals context and done. But there is a trick now. There is a certain way that we need to render out this data. So we're going to be using a for loop. So this is how we would go write about it. So we would need to just use our tags that we used before with the if statement. So we can say for. And in this case, we need to, it's like for I in range, if you recall that, or for I in index. So if you know Java or you know just basic Python, which you should know, it's very similar to that. So in this case, since it's client, I'm just going to say CL, and I'm going to say in. And we need to reference our value, for example, our key, which is client. So we need to say for CL in client. All right, close our tag. Oh, that sometimes happens. And I'm just going to end it here. So remember to put end for. And now I want to loop through that data. So I want to loop through all the IDs, the names, and the professions. So I'm just going to create simple paragraph tags here. So I'm going to create 3. Okay, and I'm just going to put like a line break in between them, just so it's a bit cleaner, of course. Okay, this. Okay, and now what we will do is we're going to use the double curly braces again in this case because we're rendering our data. And we're going to say cl.id. So that means we want to get all the IDs, we want to loop through all of this. Then we're going to use cl.name and cl.profession. So it's going to loop through all of this data. It's going to cl.name. Okay, let me remember cl. Okay, cl, not 1. Okay, just remember that. I made that mistake before. And we can just put cl.profession in the last one as well. Profession. Right, okay. So let's just indent our code a bit here so it looks a bit cleaner. So we can clearly see what's going on here. Right, so there we go. Let's check all the code here, it's fine. Ah, mistake here. So make sure that you add a colon here and not a comma like I did. Because of course you are referencing key value pairs here. So make sure that you have your colon in place here. Okay, let's just rerun our server to check this was working. Okay, that looks good, okay. Yeah, it's perfect. So let's refresh. Okay, there we go. So there is our data. So we've successfully rendered data into a HTML template. And of course, like I said, later on, we will be working with our database. Okay, of course, this is how we would go ahead and focus on the process of rendering dynamic type of data, you could say. Okay. So that's it. This is how to render data into a template in Django. We went through about 3 parts here, so you should be well prepared for it. Okay, so that's it.